Hi guys, this is Dr. Beth with Area 51 Farms, and I'm going to give you a tour of my workbench. I have a workbench. I sure do. What do I have on my workbench? I got a lot of stuff on my workbench. So I'm going to tell you. First of all, what am I doing with a workbench? Well, it's kind of a long story that I'll make a little short. Yeah, okay, so my husband has this gigantic barn, and it's enclosed. We can't open up the sides. He keeps equipment in here and does his various stuff. You know, I think they call them man sheds is another word. I don't have anything like that, and I kept playing with his tools, so he felt the need to get me my own tools, first of all. So I've got a series of these, and I really like these. I could do a review on them, but I'm not sponsored to do it. I'll mention the product name anyway. It's going to be reverse. And I have great battery packs that I can charge on here, and I can do all sorts of stuff. First time I learned there was such a thing as a power screwdriver, I just really fell in love with it. So I've got all these things, so I can start building things and kind of teaching myself how to do things. So I didn't take shop. I did home economics in school, but nonetheless, I learned by watching. Okay, that's one thing I do. I keep my tools here. Now, I have a lot of other things. I keep batteries and different electronic devices that I tool around with and find ways to cool down my chicken coops. I bought a lot of these different solar kits of different wattages, and depending on the project, I get excited. So, like, here's some things I purchased in my stack, and who knows what project I'll do later. Well, this is a game camera. We all know what you use game cameras for when you're on a farm, because you have critters and you want to see what critters are out. But I buy some really cool things to use. I have a 300 watt sine power inverter. I'm going to see what I'll use to invert with for whatever I decide project I'm going to do. This is just one of my things. I actually have a solar charge controller. Anytime you do these, you're going to need, besides an inverter, you need a charge controller to control that charge coming off those solar panels. That's another story in another time. So we'll change the topic really fast. Yeah. So I like to buy tools depending on the projects. Here's one I got the other day on Amazon. It was really inexpensive, and I have these needs to buy cool stuff, and it's a micro set. Yeah, see this? These are the tiniest little things ever, the tiniest little devices, and I can take the tiny little, like, here's one, tiny little. See how small that is? I can take those off, where the bigger tools you can't get off. I have those, and I also have all of my stamping devices for working with leather. I have tons of them. See that? These cool, there's tons of them. I could go on and on about that. These little beautiful designs that I can use to make my. Sometimes I cut out the leather and make it, and other times I use kits. I'm not very good at it, but it doesn't mean I won't try. Might as well. I tend to get things and take them apart and try to make stuff out of them. I had this broken refrigerator, and I took it apart. Yeah, I did, and can't get it back together. Some things, I take them apart, and I have no clue what they are, but it came out of the refrigerant cooling device of one of the refrigerators. I don't know. I'll have to work with that. I don't know. I took it off and I'm like, okay, there you go. What do you do? And then these circuit boards. I didn't take enough of these smaller electronics in school. When I was in college physics, I learned a little bit of electronics, but I can look at some of the circuit board and I can tell you where the resistors are and things. But once again, I didn't put it together, so I don't know. Yeah, so but you buy stuff. So then I got tons of drawers. I'll spin it around and show you the drawers that I've got here. I've got lots of, here's just an amp meter. I've got three of those. I'd love to learn more about how to use them. A lot of these different little connectors that I get, and to take off stuff and use them. Wires, I bought some electrical kits, some more solar, different solar, small solar panels. How many times can you say that twice? Here we go. Yeah, so there's another digital multimeter. Let's see if I can meter something. Let me look at some of the other drawers here. Oh yeah, I have a kit to make me some moccasins right here. I haven't done it yet, but on a cold day in the winter, I'm going to make that moccasin kit, and maybe I'll show you part of it and show you guys what they look like. I have another kit. I'm probably going to put this one together today. Yeah, I am. Here's a kit. Now, I do buy kits. You can get them here in Arkansas, Little Rock. You've actually got a store in downtown or in Little Rock, and you can buy these kits, or they'll mail order to you, and they're really good. I don't work for them either. They're called Tandy Leather if you ever want to. They're really nice people. But I got this thing that I'm going to make to hold my ID, maybe. I think I'll do that. I'll show you how to do that. I'll make that today. That's a fun thing I'm going to do. So here, let me get up and show you some more things in my tools. This, that. Oh my gosh, this drawer is full of charge controllers, inverters. Oh yeah, man, I've forgotten I bought these, and I need to do some really fun projects this winter. Here's another kit that I use to some of my tools. This is some of the bigger for larger screws and sundry things that you're going to remove. Can I show this on Facebook without getting in trouble? I'm working on a holster to put.
I missed the lid.
A holster. There you go. Oh, some more clamps. Some of my leather working stuff, some snaps, and then so here's some more stamps for my leather to, if I want to stamp a design on it, I can do that. Gosh, there's stuff I don't even know what I put down in here. Oh yeah, this is okay. This may be my most favorite. This is a customized micro screwdriver set, pretty small. But that's what you need when you work with that. This is an inverter. Yeah, that one may not work. I took that out of my coop because it wasn't, seemed to be working real well. Got weathered a little bit. I love these. I can attach these to, in fact, I'll keep this one out because I'm working on a project right now where I'm gonna need that. So, okay, so yeah. So I showed you some of that. A lot of those. So I'm going to back this up and now show it from another angle. There it is. All that stuff, a lot of it I hang up there, and then the top I got a light, my little Christian thing that belonged to my mother before she passed away, so I remember her with that. And then I have a DVD player. Sometimes I get bored and I want to watch movies. Yeah. So there we go. A battery. Don't have to tell you what that's for. Battery charger. Some of the stamp holder stuff, and then things I've taken apart. So that is my corner of this entire barn. It's the only area that I'm allowed to hang out, and I keep my own stuff here. So I hope you enjoyed my little workbench. Now show me your workbench if you've got one. I challenge you to show me your workbench or work corner or whatever it is that you like to do your hobbies. Have a nice day.